Hello and welcome, as it is the completion of the 18th day of December 2019. My name is Derek, and this is the Money Charts Channel, where, like always, all bets, trades, and of the like, within each's own risk and their own reward. And let's go over multiple time frames amongst Bitcoin and really in the long term, on the monthly, as long as it's in this weekly or the sideways move, which or range, low 3,000, upward range between like 13,000 like to 20. It's all within the sideways movement. Any price action, of course, above this, well, it'd be not that much below the 18 lows. And anything below 20,000 isn't that much above the highs. And it's in that correctionary move mode after having this little high. Any situation you can get where you have this, have your correctionary play, do situation where you see exitation, strength amongst the 18 highs, any of that type of stuff as we move forward into 2020. Well, those are just great setups to state, okay, it looks like we'd be taking this out and it would be doing so. If you see, just because this goes up like this doesn't mean it's going to go higher, meaning that this could be a failed breakout. And if that's the case, if you see weakness amongst here, that gives you the concern for the two possibilities. One, maybe not the failed breakout, but another test and stand within this range lower in the support. And if this is a failed breakout, well, the next target case would probably be where we came from back in here. And that would be at around 1,000. That's, of course, all the long-term stuff. And because we're in the middle part, it's going to be a while before you can clearly state, yeah, it's looking one way or another. So if you see any big, big moves occur, oh, Bitcoin goes up to 9, 10,000, still long ways to go. Oh, Bitcoin falls to like 5,500, still a long ways to go. So let's continue on within these time frames. Weekly chart, there's a key high, key low, key high, which is lower than this one. And whenever you have a big move, it's not a surprise to make a lower high from here to here. But on a bullish level, making that higher low is so important. And when we can see if it does fall down here from this high, well, that's just part of the whole symmetrical pattern network of making lower highs, and there's only been one, and higher lows. So will this continue further? Maybe, but we'll see. Triple day. Let's go over this quickly because the daily chart is where I want to focus this on next, which is now. And very big update today. As we can see, we had a retest of previous support. It appears below it, but man, not really. But it also appears above that significant key Fibonacci number I'm talking about, around 6,300. And I always talk about a piercing extra. Well, it hasn't yet. And from this low, we've came up to the 18 average of highs again. It retraced from it on December the 9th. It rallied from up to it, completing on December the 7th. It did so in one day and failing on December the 4th. And it did so again on November the 29th. Okay, so this is just flattening the band more than anything. There's not much. It's a possibility that it's going to attempt to revert this trend over. For how much have we had above the 18 average of highs on the daily? Well, it got above it on this failed breakout move on October the 25th. And then its high, of course, that wasn't, once it got into the 18, it never got above it since. We had a nice little small whatever mat tapped in the, around Labor Day. Nothing happened. Then we had a nice little failed breakout high here in August. And, well, this is more of that correctionary move mode in here. The move, I should say. We'll see. Maybe it's ready to do an attempt at higher. But as we move within this as we finish off this week and move forward, I really have to see like 7,600 around 7,600. For me to say, yeah, it looks like it might attempt to break out above it. Around 7,800, 7,900 most certainly would be at that point. On the 8-hour term, we can see not much resisting in this 18 whatsoever, as it just violated all previous levels of resistance amongst today's move. On the 3-hour chart, again, we're looking at this thing. Today's moves, nothing on resisting here. This little of a previous resistance in here, well, the lower end it didn't do anything with. It did about a 61.8% from this high. But that's the thing. We still, from that high, we still have that pattern of, well, key high up here. And now we've established right now that it's a lower one. And the keyword is right now. And it very easily could be. But as we look at the next levels, okay, if we get up to 77, 76, it's a match of that previous mark. Getting, and there's a lot more moves left. As I mentioned from the start, you got a long ways to go before you can say, well, we're ready to go. This is a big move, basically. On the single hour term, we can see that little failed breakdown, 8 o'clock this morning, and just a continuation move up to about 1,700 hours to 74. The length of the move was about $1,000. 64.37, 74.37, yada, yada, yada. It gained about 13%. And over the last few hours, this hour is almost over with 10 minutes left. Volatility is tiny. We have a high of $62 on the 71. We have a low of $31 on the 71. So that's a 0.5%. And really the last two, exactly the same. But we'll see how the market reacts towards this. Key Fibonacci points. If you see that it fails amongst a move like this, there's the low, there's the high. 61 somewhere around in here, like 67 change. If that doesn't hold, well, that's like we've seen it before, of course. Within this failed breakout, you can see what happens, that you can have these steady declines if, of course, that's the case. And you can see that even clearer here, or as clear, that if you get above this, start to fail down at 67, that move would easily pierce well below that 63, probably even pierce below 6,000 if that is the case. So let's finish off these shorter term time frames. 15 minute, we can see around 7 o'clock, a little bit of a failed move before it happens. And one of the things I do wonder about situations like this, and why they would always happen all the time, if I'm a big buyer, I'm just going to wait for sellers to come in for me. This is a maybe situation. And okay, so I got my buy orders in, and then they happen. So these guys come in, or whatever, they sell down to me. And then after that, and of course this would be big money speaking at this, when you're talking about this and the means to have to do it, now that your big orders got filled, okay, well, let's start buying it up. Now that you got a head start to what you're already looking to do. I don't know, stuff like that I kind of wonder, but the volume is most certainly noticeable in here, as we had much higher volume than this than we had from everything preceding it beforehand. So. But hey, we'll see how this continues on moving into the final weeks of December. And the final view on the daily, when you look at the volume here, I mean, there's still nothing to get too excited about with this volume when you compare it to the fact that it didn't get above any of these previous days high. But still, that is how Bitcoin is looking, at least from my point of view. And I'd like to thank you for tuning in and have yourself a great day. Bye-bye.